Broadening Horizons program was born out of the Missing Elements report, which was conducted back in 2021. And this really highlighted the lived experiences of Black and ethnic minorities in the chemical sciences and the challenges they face. And as someone being in the pharmaceutical industry for the last 10 years, I could really relate to this.
They did look at HISA data, which suggested that the number of Black chemistry professors was 0%. And they then looked around in chemistry departments and they didn't find any other. So they came back to me and confirmed that at that time I was the only Black chemistry professor. Now clearly that suggested very poor representation of Black heritage individuals in higher levels of the chemical sciences. And it was, of course, then the Missing Elements report that was launched and which has had a significant impact, and many have considered that report to be a watershed moment.
Where I grew up and also the university that I went to wasn't very diverse. So being in a room full of chemists that look like me is the best feeling ever. Like I can't even describe it because it's just, I've never felt anything like it before. And I hope that I get to have that feeling again in the future.
Broadening Horizons is a 3-year pilot program aimed at increasing the retention and progression of Black and ethnic minority postgraduate and undergraduate students in the chemical sciences. The 4 main pillars include our taster event, which gives the opportunity for our students to meet our industry partners, as well as networking and building that peer relationship amongst the cohort. Secondly, we have the site visits, which offer the opportunity for in-person, day-in-the-life experiences of what it's like to be in the industry. We also have ringfenced placements, which offer exclusive opportunities to our students to have summer internships with our partner companies, increasing their likelihood of staying in the chemical sciences. And finally, we have ongoing relationships with our cohort, providing one-to-one mentorship through our RSC mentorship program, as well as drop-in sessions and online sessions with our partners.
When I applied to this program, I didn't know that I would be getting these kind of opportunities. I would really got the chance to have a like one-on-one session with them, with my mentors. That is so supporting. We don't really get these kind of opportunities in like normal daily life. This program is so productive, and I would really encourage others to also apply and join this program as well.
To be able to walk into a room and see a lot of people that look like me, a lot of women that look like me, was the biggest standout thing. Because for a long while there was a point in time where I wanted to just to stop. And then I kind of, being on the course, being on this program actually, kind of reignited my fire.
There was ring fence placements that were advertised only through the scheme. And I applied to one of those, which I was successful in getting, which is amazing. So from September, I'll be pausing the PhD for a year and going to spend a year in industry, which I completely wouldn't have had without this project. One, because I didn't know that they existed. And two, because I wouldn't have had the support there to learn how to go through the process, how to open those conversations up, how to write a proper CV. it's been absolutely fantastic.
Seeing so many people and so many people that look like me, it just, my first initial reaction was like, whoa, like this is awesome.
I'm seeing the faces of the other attendees. It just made me realize they're all in the same position as me.
So please do feel free to network with me during the program.
Coming from a family background where nobody had gone to university, nobody understood what I was going through studying a STEM subject in the UK. So no, without the RSC, I would not have received the well-guided mentoring and very tailored advice that helped me optimize my career path. So the RSC mentoring scheme is definitely something that I'm so grateful for.
I would go into a company and I'd be one of three Black people, or two or three Black people in the company with 100, 200 employees. And you think to yourself, wow, this is very underrepresentative.
What's really important to me is that we create a climate of change for our chemical sciences, so that it doesn't matter what part of the culture we belong to, we feel like there is a sense of belonging and there is a place for everyone within the chemical sciences.
One of the things that I said to the group today is that the reality is that the opportunities that they have are far greater and far more diverse than the opportunities that somebody at this, my stage of my career would have had when I was their age. And that is positive. I think what we have to ensure is that those opportunities that are available to everybody, and nobody feels excluded from having those opportunities, so that people then can do what they really want to do and thrive and grow and make their contributions in the best way they can.
The one that's really stuck to my head is when Dr. Mukayo came and talked. The reason is he's Kenyan, I'm Kenyan, and I didn't even think, oh, the Royal Society of Chemistry is going to be led by someone who's Black in the first place. I didn't even know about that, and I didn't even know about him being the only Black professor in the UK. It was kind of like inspiring, especially because I just saw similarities.
I walked in this morning and in a way I felt that sense of belonging without even having to speak to somebody yet.
We've spent a lot of time thinking about how best to engage and to make a real difference in the programme. So we have a huge amount of work placements that we're going to bring people into. And also we've engaged our talent team as well. So they have a portal to go through to look at the work placements. They're in different geographical locations. And I've met some really bright and very, very articulate students. So we're really looking forward to actually employing some at the end of their journey.
When you come from a different background, this doesn't need to be an impediment, but actually you can see that as a superpower, something that is giving you a unique advantage. Once you understand your own background in that way, I think can be very enabling.
We've had over 300 scholars come through the programme. We've offered over 200 site visits to over 16 sites, and we've had over 40 placements offered. But we're not done yet.
What we now need to do is to think about how we will expand this program in I would say two ways, both in terms of its reach and its impact, just to make sure that the impact is deeper and is really changing the chemical sciences in terms of that pipeline and in terms of the number of people that we can reach, even perhaps thinking going beyond just those of Black heritage to include other disadvantaged communities within the chemical sciences and beyond.
When you can walk away with influencing a couple of individuals who are going to exit the chemical sciences because they didn't feel a sense of belonging, and you've made that change in their mindset, that's a real valuable asset for our chemistry community. But this isn't enough. I think this is the beginning.
Since joining Unilever, it's opened my eyes to a completely different world, that is industry. And I made quite a drastic decision. You know, a role came up at Unilever and I applied for it and I was very lucky. So I'm now a permanent member of staff at Unilever, which is incredible. And I would not have got that opportunity without doing the Broadening Horizons program. It also took, you know, them to put a little bit of a bet on me because I didn't have the usual skill sets that a medical affairs scientist would normally have. But I was able, through the program, to gain the skills and to show my capabilities, nurture them during the internship, and now here we are.